Hello and welcome. I'm Raghav, and in this session, we are going to learn how to create Gradle project in Eclipse from scratch. And as always, we are going to go very basic step by step. So we are going to learn how to add Gradle plugin in Eclipse, how to add Gradle location in Eclipse, how to create a new Gradle project in Eclipse. And then finally, we will see how to add Gradle dependencies in our project. So let's get started. And here, step number one will be add Gradle plugin in Eclipse. And I hope you have already installed Gradle on your systems. If not, you can watch the earlier video. If you go to my website, that is automationstepbystep.com. So if you go here, you will find all the tutorials on Gradle here. So here on the website, if you scroll down to the tutorials, you will see build tools, and we have Gradle here. So click on Gradle. This will take you to a YouTube playlist, and here you can find all the videos on Gradle. So we have already seen what is Gradle, how to install on Windows, and how to install on Mac. And also, I'm assuming that you have Eclipse already set up on your system. Just in case you need help with that, again, you can go to the website, and under programming, you will find a Java section, a Java tutorial. Again, this will take you to the YouTube playlist on Java. And here I have this video on getting started with Eclipse, so you can watch that in case you do not have Eclipse. So I'm assuming we have Eclipse now, and the first step is add Gradle plugin in Eclipse. I will go to my Eclipse, and here when you go to Windows and go to you have to go to Help and Eclipse Marketplace. And even before you do this, let us check if Gradle is already present. And it may happen that if you are using a latest version of Eclipse, you already have Gradle. And the way to check that is, if you go to your file and go to New, and here you can go to Other. So this is File, New, Other. And here it will open this Select a Wizard window. Now here, start typing Gradle, and in case you see something like this, Gradle project, that means you do not need to add the plugin for Gradle. So check this before you add the plugin, and in case you do not get this, then go to Help and go to Eclipse Marketplace. So this is Help and Eclipse Marketplace. And here on this search text box or the find text box, start typing Gradle and hit enter, and this should show you all the Gradle plugins available. So you can see all these Gradle plugins. Now we need here this plugin from Buildship Gradle. So this is a good plugin that you can get, Buildship Gradle integration. You can get whatever is the latest version, and in my case it is already installed, and that was the reason I was getting the option for creating a new Gradle project. So once you do this, restart your Eclipse. So let me also put it here. This you will get from Eclipse Marketplace, and you can go to Help in Eclipse Marketplace, and then we have to restart Eclipse. And let me also show you my Eclipse that I am using. So if I go to Help and go to About Eclipse, so this is the Eclipse version I am using, which is 2.0.1.9.0.9 release 4.13. So this is just for information if you want to compare. Now, once we have done the first step, that is add Gradle plugin, second step will be we have to add Gradle location in Eclipse. Now this you can do while you are creating a new Gradle project, or you can also do directly from Windows, the menu, Window, and go to Preferences. And here you should see a Gradle option here, and then here we have this option for local installation directory. So here you can put the folder of your Gradle. Now in my case, if you are on Windows, we have already seen this earlier as well in the earlier session where we installed Gradle on Windows. So wherever you have unzipped the folder of Gradle, so let's say in my case it was under D tools and I have this Gradle folder here. So this is the location I need to provide. Now just in case you are on a Mac operating system, you can go to terminal, and in our case we have used brew to install Gradle. So we have done brew install Gradle, and now to get the location of Gradle folder, I can say brew info Gradle, and this should show me the location of Gradle. So you can see here the location of Gradle on my Mac is this one, this folder. I can just go here, copy this location and say open and this location, or you can also go to your Finder and press Command Shift G. This is a combination of Command Shift G key on your keyboard, and here you can put this location and say go, and you can see here, or let me open it from here, you can see this is the location of Gradle folder on Mac. So you just have to copy this location and then you can provide this here. And as I said, if you do not want to do it globally, you can also do while you are creating a new Gradle project. So let me just do it from here. I will say apply and close. And now next step is, after you have added the location, step number three is create a new Gradle project. So now I will go to my file menu, go to new, and here I can go to others, and now here I should be having Gradle. You can also search here Gradle and it should show you. So let me show you again, file, new, others, Gradle, and I will select Gradle project here and say next. Now here some information, I will click on next again, and here I can give a project name. So I will say this is my first Gradle project, and you can see now it has taken the location. So this is the location of the project. Let me show you the Gradle location as well. This is where the project will get saved. In case you want to change it, you can change that. And then do not worry about this add project to working set. This is just to show to organize projects in working sets. Click on next. And now here you can see it is showing this local installation directory that we had set in the earlier step. Just in case you want to override this, you can click on override, and you can also select the Gradle folder location by browsing here. So now I will just go and click on next again, and you can see now it will create the Gradle project. It is giving us all this information. This is the project root directory, this is the Gradle user home directory here. So this is the home directory of Gradle, and usually you will have a .gradle file created when you install and set up Gradle on your system. For example, if I show you in my system, if I go to C drive and go to users, and you can go to your user, in my case it is administrator, and here I have this .gradle file. So this is like a local repository for Gradle on this system. All the jars, dependencies of Gradle will be stored and managed from here. So this is what it is showing here, the Gradle user home directory, and this is the local directory or folder of Gradle, Gradle version, and the Java home directory. I will say finish, and this will create the project. So you can see the project is created, my first Gradle project here. If I now expand this project or this folder, you will see a build.gradle file, and this is where we can add all our dependencies. In case you have used Maven, this is similar to pom.xml file of Maven where we add all our dependencies. So you can see we have a dependencies section here, and we can add our dependencies here. So the next step is we have created a Gradle project. I will say add dependencies. So we can check how do we add dependencies in Gradle. So let us say I want to add libraries or dependencies for Selenium. So I will go to the dependencies section in the build.gradle file and I will search for Selenium Gradle dependencies. I will say Selenium Gradle dependency on Google and search for it. And you can see we have got this option from Maven repository. So I will go here. And Maven repository also has dependencies for Gradle and other build tools, not just for Maven. So you can see when I go to Selenium Java, here we have Maven dependency, but we also have Gradle here. And when you just click, it will be copied. And then I will go to the dependencies section in the build.gradle file and just paste it here and save my project. Now, if you go to this folder, that is project and external dependencies, and if I expand this, you can see these are the dependencies already added. However, I cannot see the Selenium dependencies that I have just added. So for that, what you can do is you can do a right click on the project or on this project and external dependencies folder, and here or you can do a right click on the build.gradle file and you have a Gradle option here. Now here, if you see something like refreshed dependencies, for example, if I go here, if you see refreshed dependencies or refreshed Gradle project, you can do that. And also I am on a package explorer. So if I go to this quick access and I say, if I say here, Project Explorer, you can see we can see our project as a Project Explorer or a Package Explorer as well. In my case, I am using a Package Explorer. And now I will do a right click on the project or on build.gradle file and go to Gradle and say refresh Gradle project. And now you can see all the Selenium dependencies that I have added are now present here in this folder. So this is how you can add and manage dependencies in Gradle project in Eclipse. And this is how we can create a Gradle project in Eclipse. I hope this session was very useful for you. Thank you for watching.